Consider the animation that is playing on the screen. Over here, two rods of same length and same thickness, but different materials have been considered, and they are being heated to the same extent. We have considered an iron rod that is shown in black and an aluminium rod that is shown in white. Now, when we are supplying the same amount of heat energy, they are undergoing expansion. But as you can see, the amount of expansion is different for both the rods. Iron is expanding less, that is, it is expanding to a lesser length as compared to aluminium, which is expanding to a greater length. So why do you think this is happening, that even though we are supplying the same amount of heat, they are undergoing different expansions? Consider another scenario. Over here, we have considered two rods and we are applying the same heat to them, and they are of the same material, aluminium. But as you can see, their initial lengths are different. Now, when we are applying the same amount of heat energy to these rods, the rod which has a longer length is undergoing greater expansion than the rod which has a lesser length. Again, we have considered the same material and we are applying the same amount of heat energy. So why do you think the expansion is different for both the rods? We consider a third scenario. Over here, we have taken two rods of same length and thickness and of same material, but we are applying different amount of heat energy. So we will find that to the rod to which you are applying more heat energy, that is the outer rod, that rod is expanding more as compared to the inner rod, which is expanding less. You will find that if you supply twice the amount of heat energy as compared to the other rod, the expansion in length will be two times as much. Thus, we can say that when a solid body is expanding, in this case a rod, the increase in length is dependent upon three factors. What are those three factors? Firstly, it depends upon the material of the rod. As we saw in the first case, iron and aluminium of the same length being supplied the same heat energy were not expanding in a similar manner. Secondly, it is directly proportional to the original length. Or in other words, as we saw, greater the initial length, more will be the amount of expansion. Lesser the initial length, less will be the amount of expansion. And lastly, we found that it is directly proportional to the increase in temperature. So if you are supplying a greater amount of heat energy, we are ensuring that the increase in its temperature is more. So more we increase the temperature, more will be the expansion. Lesser that we increase the temperature, less will be the expansion. So it is directly proportional to an increase in its temperature. So now we find out the respective mathematical relations for three different cases. Firstly, we have considered a thin rod. Now, at 0 degree centigrade, this thin rod has a length L0 or L0. Now, we are heating it to a temperature of T degree Celsius. So, we are increasing the temperature through T degree Celsius, that is from 0 to T. And the expansion that it is undergoing and the length which it is getting after being heated is LT. So we can say that the expansion of the rod is LT minus L0. That is the change in length or the increase in length. So the initial length of the rod at 0 degree Celsius is L0. After we are heating it through T degree Celsius, the length of the rod is becoming LT. So we can say that the increase in length is nothing but the difference in between the final length LT and initial length L0. So mathematically, LT minus L0. Now we have studied that this change in length or the expansion is directly proportional to two things. It is directly proportional to the original length and also directly proportional to the change in temperature, that is T degree Celsius. So if we combine equations 1 and 2, we can write that LT minus L0 is directly proportional to L0 into T. Thus, we get this expression. Now, if we have to convert this into an expression of equality, we will need to introduce a proportionality constant. So the proportionality constant that we introduce is alpha. So alpha is the proportionality constant that we are introducing to get an equality relation. This proportionality constant alpha is known as the coefficient of linear expansion. As you can see, alpha, the proportionality constant, is known as the coefficient of linear expansion. So let us find out how we can calculate the value of alpha. Now, the original equation that we had is LT minus L0 is equal to alpha into L0 into T. So once we rearrange this equation, thus we get, after rearranging, that alpha is equal to LT minus L0 divided by L0 into T. That is nothing but the increase in length divided by original length times the rise in temperature. So how can we define alpha? If we consider a rod, a thin rod, that has an initial length of 1 unit, that is unit length. And if we increase its temperature by 1 degree Celsius or 1 unit, then alpha is nothing but the increase in length LT minus L0. Thus, we can define alpha as the coefficient of linear expansion of a substance is numerically equal to the increase in length of a rod, that is LT minus L0, of a particular substance of unit length. Unit length when its temperature is increased by 1 degree Celsius. So if L0 is 1 and T is 1, we can say alpha is equal to LT minus L0, that is the increase in length. So now we consider a thin sheet, A, B, C, D. Now initially at 0 degree Celsius, this thin sheet has an area of A0 or A0. Now we heat it through T degrees Celsius, as a result of which it undergoes surface expansion or superficial expansion, because it is a thin sheet. So the area after expansion at T degrees Celsius is AT. So initially the area of the plate is A0 at 0 degrees Celsius. After heating it through T degrees Celsius, the area of the plate becomes AT. So the increase in area is numerically equal to AT minus A0. That is the expansion in area. Now we have seen in case of solids that it will be dependent upon two things. Because we are considering surface expansion, the expansion will be directly proportional to the original area, as well as it will be directly proportional to the rise in temperature. So if we combine these two equations, we will get AT minus A0, that is the increase in area, is directly proportional to A0 into T. So now we see that we are getting a proportionality equation by combining equations 4 and 5. Now, in order to convert this into an equality relation, we have to introduce a proportionality constant. So now I introduce a proportionality constant, beta. This proportionality constant beta has a particular name. So the proportionality constant that I'm introducing, beta, is known as the coefficient of superficial expansion or the coefficient of surface expansion. So let us now find out how we can express beta mathematically. So the original relation that we have is AT minus A0 equals beta into A0 into T. So if I rearrange this equation, I can write AT minus A0, and I bring A0T on this side. So I get nothing but beta is equal to AT minus A0 divided by A0 into T. Thus, we can say that beta is nothing but an increase in the area after expansion divided by the original area times rise in temperature. So how can we define beta? If we consider a sheet which has 1 unit square area, and if we make the rise in temperature, or if we increase its temperature by 1 degree Celsius, then beta is nothing but the increase in area that it is undergoing. So numerically, the coefficient of superficial expansion of a substance is numerically equal to the increase in area of a plate of that substance of unit area when its temperature is increased by 1 degree Celsius. Just like in the case of the coefficient of linear expansion, even in the case of the coefficient of superficial expansion, the unit is degree Celsius to the power minus 1, or per degree Celsius. So when A0 is 1 meter square, or 1 unit, and T is 1 degree Celsius, we can say beta is equal to the change in area. Now we consider a third scenario where we are considering a volume. Now over here, we can find a cube is considered which has a volume V0. It has a definite length, breadth, and height or thickness. So initially at 0 degree Celsius, we consider the volume of the cube is V0. And once we heat it through T degree Celsius, the volume of the cube becomes VT. So the increase in volume, or the change in volume, is numerically equal to VT minus V0, that is the final volume minus initial volume. So even in this case, the change or the increase in volume will be dependent upon two things. It will be directly proportional to the original or initial volume, and it will be directly proportional to the change or the rise in temperature. So if I combine equations 7 and 8, I get Vt minus V0 is directly proportional to V0 into T. So thus, I get this particular relation. Now, in order to make this relation a relation of equality, I have to introduce a proportionality constant. So the proportionality constant I introduce is gamma. Gamma also has a particular name. So the proportionality constant that I have introduced is known as gamma. And this proportionality constant is also known as the coefficient of cubical or volumetric expansion. Now, just like we calculated mathematically in the case of alpha and beta, let us see how we can mathematically calculate the value of gamma, or the coefficient of cubical expansion. So we have the relation that is Vt minus V0 equals gamma into V0 into T. So if I rearrange this equation, what will I get? I will get Vt minus V0 divided by, I bring this quantity to the denominator, and thus I can write gamma as Vt minus V0 divided by V0 into T. Thus we can define gamma as mathematically the increase in volume divided by the original volume times the rise in temperature. So how can we define gamma? We can say that if you are considering an initial volume of 1 unit cube, and if you are increasing the temperature by 1 degree Celsius, we can say that gamma is nothing but the expansion or the increase in volume Vt minus V0. Thus, the coefficient of cubical expansion or volumetric expansion of a substance is numerically equal to the increase in volume when we are considering a cube of unit volume of that substance and its temperature is being increased by 1 degree Celsius. Its unit is also per degree Celsius, or degrees Celsius to the power of minus 1. Now experimentally, it has been found out that there is a relationship that exists in between alpha, beta and gamma. That is the coefficients of linear expansion, surface expansion and volume expansion. And this relation is a very simple relation, as you can see. That is, the ratio in between these three quantities, alpha is to beta is to gamma, is equal to 1 is to 2 is to 3. And it has been experimentally found out by scientists. So taking a quick recap, we learned about three quantities. These three quantities, as I told you, are alpha, beta and gamma. Respectively, the coefficient of linear expansion, the coefficient of superficial expansion or surface expansion, and the coefficient of cubical or volumetric expansion. And also we found out how we can express them mathematically. And lastly, we saw that these three quantities have a very simple relation in between them. That is, alpha is to beta is to gamma is equal to 1 is to 2 is to 3.